Some people are targeted because they're in swing districts. Mm-hmm. Some people are targeted because they're real outspoken. But you seem to be targeted because you're able to do things that advance the agenda, and they haven't quite figured out how to stop you yet. Now, the latest attempt has been to remove you from the Oversight Committee and from the Natural Resources mm-hmm. Committee. Walk me through how you see your role in the Congress in the coming months.
So now what they did is they took my, as you said, took my committees away. So now I sit on all committees. It's how you look at it. You know, so you're going to hurt me. I like being busy. So I'm going to be on the floor. I'm going to be in the committees that I want to be on the issues that are pertinent. And
that kind of sounds like someone we know, doesn't it?
Yes.
Doesn't that sound like Marjorie Taylor Greene?
It does.
Are we building a new model here for members that really audit the body more than serve one particular interest or group or policy area on committees?
It is. And what's so magic about this, Matt, is that the committee structure is broken.
Uh-huh.
Committee staff runs it. It's not the members.
And what most people don't realize is it's the special interests and lobbyists who lobby the committees
yeah.
who then turn around and tell the leadership which members they want on those committees.
Yeah.
So it's not really a fair fight with the lobby corps against the rest of America because the lobby corps has picked the referee.
You're exactly right. So why play by their rules? Mm-hmm. Establish our own rules. You know, and what I like about you and Marjorie Taylor Greene, Lauren Boebert, you know, Jody Heiss, Andy Biggs, is we're all asking, why do you do that?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I like the fact that we question, and how does this get us back to what?
Mm-hmm.
You know, sound policy. You know, it's like the idea that we've talked about with the NDAA, this recent NDAA. We should have held it up. We had the perfect storm. We've had mm-hmm. military generals who made millions off the Iraqi-Afghanistan war. The industrial complex that Eisenhower warned us about. We saw the leaving of 80-some billion dollars worth of our equipment behind. We saw a hurried...
Well, just a totally incompetent withdrawal.
Totally incompetent.